And look at that climb there. Juan's pushing on it. Morishita's was just prepared to settle next to him. You can tell how much they're hurting now. Oh, that one really did hurt. Imagine coming up to 40 kilometers and having to climb as steeply as that.
But neither giving way.
Well, this is exactly like the women's marathon. There were two of them together at this stage. It was a Japanese and a unified team, Yegorova, who eventually won it, but it was this competitive.
They really are suffering. It's been a head-to-head for the last 7-8 miles.
If this wasn't the Olympic marathon, the runners of this caliber wouldn't be here, because the course is far too difficult. It's really tough. 39 kilometers there, Freigang, and there's another little respite. They've actually tried to help them by taking them through the park so that they climb in steps rather than all the way at once. And we know what it's like walking up from the broadcasting center to the stadium, but I wouldn't like to be doing it after 20 miles. Freigang there, still going strong. He's having his run on the level, and the other two are just beginning their next climb. And their racing is just like who's going to get first to the next winning post, isn't it?
The road looked fairly clear ahead of Freigang, so he's perhaps lost sight of them. But the course does twist and turn on the climb up the hill. Well, they certainly are racing. They're not flinching. There's a fierce competitive attitude between the two of them, obviously. There's a flash from the course that there's a gap between first and second and third, of about 10 to 11 seconds. And that'll take some making up at this stage.
Well, I'm just reflecting on the fact that over the last few years, we've become used to the idea that the older men win the marathons. But Morishita's only 25, Huang's only 22, and Freigang in third place is only 24. And that's a real turn-up for the book. It's always been expected that you need to be close to 30 when you came to your best at this particular distance, but these three seem to be proving that wrong. And look how determined. They're just trying to get one gap. I think one gap of more than about 15 or 20 meters would be sufficient here. And the one who gets it first, I guess, will win the race.
Huang is the one applying the pressure. Looks the more powerful of the two. But the Japanese, more of a floater. The real pain of the marathon. And so many coaches came over. They couldn't believe this finish could be so severe. They came to inspect it specially. And all their worst fears were confirmed. And here we have two men absolutely locked together. Now, slight gap appearing. Huang is beginning to break the Japanese. He's on the downhill stretch first, and he's stolen a few meters. And this is the break for home. Still taking water on board, but he's got the gap he wanted. And he looks so strong.
Well, not surprisingly, that was the slowest 5 kilometer split in the whole race. 16 minutes and 30 seconds. And that's more than a minute slower than the previous one. But the climbing, the late stage in the race, and the tiredness has obviously crept into them after that severe punishing run earlier on. And Huang, it looks as though he's broken away from Morishita.
And Freigang is in the picture now, in third place. Just saw him coming into shot. hidden behind the trees, the Olympic Stadium. The break, clear and decisive. He attacked on all the hills, and on the final hill it paid off.
But this is the worst bit of the climb, this bit here. It's almost 1 in 10 for about 100 metres there, and they turn the corner and they really begin to climb again.
This is a little more gentle than the severe ones in the park and at the bottom of the mountain. But he's still full of running. He's about 1,500 metres from the finish. It's Nakayama now showing in third place ahead of Freigang. Well, he's closed some distance up there. And Nakayama has had a yo-yo sort of race. He's been up and down the field, up and down the field, coming and going. But he's going very well at the moment.
Well, about 10 miles ago, we thought it was all over for Nakayama, but he's really dug deep. He was fourth in the last Olympic Games, and he must have been reminding himself he wanted a medal, because I imagine this will be his last Olympic Games. And look at Wang. My goodness, he doesn't want to give it away now. You can see the stadium, and he approaches it, and they're still climbing up towards the stadium. But he's done enough now to surely not relent and not give it away. He's just got to keep working. He's still got to keep climbing.
2 hours, 9 minutes, 30 seconds showing on the clock. So it's a fast one on this course. While ahead in the stadium, the crowd is gathering for the closing ceremony, but the Korean group there getting very excited indeed. It's the competitors' area, and they're watching the events unfold on the big screen. And it's looking like the marathon gold for Korea. Morishita still pushing hard. Nakayama with his private battle with Freigang. So at the moment we've got Korea in the gold medal position and Japan in the silver and bronze position with Germany fourth. Well, that red strip, a welcome sight for the Korean. Leads to the stadium tunnel entrance. Still pushing hard. Morishita in second place. I wonder if he knows his teammate Nakayama is closing. This is going to be quite a race for the bronze because they're pretty well on the flat now. Fang still pumping away with those arms, driving himself on.
Well, he'd have been dreaming about this one. Approaching the Olympic Stadium in the lead in the Olympic Marathon. And they're still climbing though. It's still tough. You can see how much it's hurting him. And the race is on for second place and third and fourth. But Huang, there's Morishita in second place. Huang in the lead. Looks as though it's going to be his gold medal. Nakayama there, and there a welcome sight for any athlete.
Huang of Korea, first into the Olympic Stadium in this 1992 marathon. The Korean team rise in salute. Mm-hmm. only 22, may well be the youngest Olympic marathon winner ever. Morishita in second place of Japan. Nakayama third, with Freigang of Germany in fourth place. And they face a battle on the track.
Well, this is the race that nobody wants. They don't want to be coming out of the Olympic Stadium together. But who's it going to be? What a race it's going to be for third.
The champion looks round and starts to celebrate. Young Cho Huang, 22. The marathon winner for Korea. An epic race, a magnificent winner. 2:13:23 the time. Lies on the track. Tiredness being mocked. He's going to be helped up as Morishita comes in. The race for third place is on, though. Morishita takes the silver for Japan. And what a battle for third place. And it's being won by Freigang. Freigang's just got away from Nakayama on the last lap. And the bronze goes to Germany. With Nakayama in fourth place, the position he occupied in Seoul 4 years ago. Well, the first two immediately went down to the track for a rest, so too does Freigang. And this is a really tough marathon. Bettiol in fifth place, the Italian. Kakech of Morocco is the next man in sixth place. Hurek of Poland in seventh. Taniguchi, the world champion, in eighth place. And how unlucky he was. He fell at one of the feeding stations. His shoe was ripped off. And he's worked his way back in. And now the first of the Spaniards coming in. Celebrating. It's Garcia. Followed by Kim, the other Korean, who was in the battle for the three lead places for so long, but dropped off dramatically in the closing stages. So, a Korean takes the gold medal. A Korean actually won it in 36, but he had to run for Japan. But this time, the nation of Korea can celebrate a gold medal they've been waiting for a long, long time.